to 37-64. Elvis Presley, Boulevard. Hit it, Elvis. You got me.
Welcome to another edition of Elvis Back on Tour. Today we're in Johnson City, Tennessee, site of Freedom Hall, where Elvis performed four shows, three in 1976 in March, and then one show in February of 1977. This is one of the smaller venues that we found that Elvis played, seating only 7,000 fans.
Freedom Hall opened in 1974 and is part of the Liberty Bell Complex and sits adjacent to the local middle school and high school in Johnson City. When Elvis arrived, his limousine would have traveled down this road behind the Civic Center. This is the overhead door that Elvis's limousine would have pulled in. Once inside, Elvis was about 50 yards from where he would have entered the stage.
This is one of those buildings that has been renovated numerous times since Elvis's time here, but the footprint still remains. And we've got a lot of footage from backstage where we can show you the walk up, just as Elvis did back in the day. And we can show you exactly where the car came in, how he got on stage, the path that he took. And we're really looking forward to showing that to you.
One of our favorite lineups from this building is a photo of Elvis with the state trooper just before he stepped on stage. Freedom Hall is one of the few locations that has a photo of Elvis's stage set up. Note how different the inside of the building looks today. Elvis's performances in Johnson City offered many opportunities for lineups.
Yeah.
We always like to show fans the hotel Elvis used for a certain venue. While in Johnson City, Elvis used what was then the Holiday Inn at 536 Volunteer Parkway in Bristol, Tennessee, 30 minutes away from Freedom Hall.
This is the site of what was the Holiday Inn during Elvis's four stays here. So he would have stayed here for the three shows that he performed in 1976 and then the show that he performed in 1977. Now here is where we will show you newspaper clippings of where his car would have been parked to get him out of here, and this is where the bus would have been parked to also get the band and so forth out of here. Up here is where the suite would have been, up on the top floor. All these rooms would have been taken up by band and orchestra, bodyguards, things like that. But this is the route right here that Elvis would have taken. We'll also include pictures of Elvis coming in and out of this area right here. We'll include pictures that will show you this wall. The wall's changed a little bit, it's been painted, but it's still the same wall. And then we're gonna show you, in the video that we do, we're gonna show you the route that Elvis took right here to get up to the suite. The manager here was kind enough to take us upstairs and give us a quick tour, and we'll share that with you in the upcoming video.
So just to give you a little bit of perspective, when Elvis stayed here back in the day, it was a Holiday Inn. Elvis stayed here for his three shows in 76 and then for the one show in 77. Stayed here each time that he played Johnson City. Basically, take you up the route that he would have taken. Very secure area. And again, going back almost 50 years now. So you can obviously see that many things have changed, but I'm certain that back in the day that this was a very nice place. So just to put it into perspective, this pink door here would have been the door, we're told by the manager here, that would have led to the top floor suite. And in the newspaper clippings that we'll include in this video, you're gonna see this parking lot come into play. The bus used to take everybody over to the Civic Center would have been parked there along with Elvis's car. And a lot of people sometimes ask, why the bus? Obviously, when they were on the road, it wasn't just Elvis, it was orchestra, band, Elvis's entourage, so you had to have a way to get them moved around, so a bus would have been the way to go.
While in Bristol, Michael and I spent time researching the history of the Holiday Inn and found the story behind the suite on the top floor. Jack Traer, born in 1909, was a very prominent businessman in Bristol. He was very successful in the restaurant and hospitality industry. He built and owned the first Holiday Inn in Bristol and lived in the suite on the top floor. When Elvis came to town on tour, Elvis was invited to use Mr. Traer's suite. Mr. Traer died in 2006.
So when Elvis took his walk with the guys headed to the show, he would have come out of this suite. Basically, taking the same trip that we're taking right now. There's that piece of concrete that Elvis was stepping on that we'll include that photo in the video. So it would have been that piece right there. And then this is the wall. Obviously the wall's been painted. I don't think it's been changed, but I can't confirm that. But it's definitely been painted and some
pipe, drain pipe, and things like that have been added. But we just wanted to bring you here and kind of show you where it all took place almost 50 years ago.
While working on this video, I was moved when I saw this photograph. I imagined how hard at times it must have been to be Elvis Presley and demand every minute, rarely a quiet moment.
Some of the most famous photos of Elvis in the Johnson City, Bristol area are these photos of Elvis leaving and arriving after his performances in 1976. And with most photos we can line up, we stood in the same spot where the king once stood.
Some fans have heard the story of a bridge built from the suite to a neighborhood behind the hotel. Rumors are it was built for Elvis to leave unnoticed. Many locals say it was built for Mr. Traer. We do not have enough information to confirm who it was built for. In our opinion, it was not built for Elvis, as all the pictures we've seen show Elvis leaving via the parking lot. Nothing that we do at Elvis Back on Tour would be possible without the help of many people along the way. We want to say thank you to Randy Collins and our dear friend Bobby Shirley, who we met several years ago. She worked when Elvis came to town and just recently retired after 45 years of service to Freedom Hall.
Thank you for watching. Be sure to check out our other videos from across the country. Subscribe and comment to let us know what you think. Also, share this video so others can enjoy. Along with information about this video, we have provided a link in the description to take you to all the social media platforms Elvis Back on Tour is on.